T-Tube, Sunday, April 24, 2022. Today is Jesus Agazian Easter. May God change the crisis in Tigray and help us to say Happy Easter. Now, we are not happy, we are stuck at God Friday, our people is suffering approximately for 5 years and in a grave genocide for 18 months. We are not celebrating Easter, we are not living our lives, we are extremely worrying on the people of Tigray. Today news, headlines. We are being targeted to be eliminated, it's not secure to go back to Ethiopia and we want to be the voice of the people of Tigray. Ethiopian peacekeepers from Tigray seek asylum in Sudan.
Ethiopia's peace pegged on humanitarian corridors.
Ethiopian peacekeepers from Tigray seek asylum in Sudan. Ethiopian troops were the backbone of a peacekeeping force in a disputed Sudanese border region. More than 500 UN peacekeepers from Ethiopia's war-torn Tigray region have refused to return home, citing fears for their safety and highlighting deepening ethnic fissures as they request political asylum in Sudan. Until last year, Ethiopian forces accounted for the vast majority of the around 4,000-member peacekeeping mission in Abyei, UNISFA, a disputed border region between Sudan and South Sudan. The Ethiopian contingent was replaced by a multinational force as ties between Addis Ababa and Khartoum deteriorate over a territorial dispute and Ethiopia's mega dam on the Blue Nile, which Sudan fears will threaten its access to water. Most of the Ethiopian forces have returned home, but some have now requested asylum, a UN peacekeeping spokesperson told AFP in New York. The region of 10 million people, around 10% of Ethiopia's population, has been under a de facto blockade, according to the UN. Tigray is living in darkness. Tigrayan officers were purged from Federal Army ranks soon after the war erupted, while ordinary Tigrayans have described being subjected to arbitrary arrests in Addis Ababa. Peacekeepers from Tigray previously went back to Ethiopia. Some of them were arrested, some killed, said Gebre Kidan, who has been based in Abyei since July 2020. Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed sent troops into Tigray in November 2020. The people of Tigray have been living in darkness and the international community is watching in silence. We want to make the international community pay attention. The Ethiopian government has not responded to AFP's calls for comment on the troops' request for asylum. A second Tigrayan officer told AFP that he too had asked for asylum like his comrades but refused to say anything further for fear of reprisals against his family. A third soldier, who spoke to AFP on condition of anonymity for similar reasons, said he had asked for asylum to express my strong opposition to the federal government's treatment of Tigrayans. Furthermore, he said senior officers like him have a military background and knowledge, therefore we are considered as a main challenging force by the government. So we are being targeted to be eliminated, he said. His children understood his reasons for staying out of Ethiopia, he explained, if I go there, they know what will happen to me. We are now in the good hands of UNHCR, he said, adding, I hope for the better tomorrow to come.
Ethiopia's peace pegged on humanitarian corridors. The fake and unclear peace negotiation between TPLF and the butcher Abiy Ahmed is gravely damaging the people of Tigray, Sunday, April 24, 2022, statement from AFP. Humanitarian corridors into Ethiopia's Tigray region may now be the country's hope for lasting peace, after efforts for an immediate diplomatic solution hit a wall. This week, the Tigray People's Liberation Front, TPLF, the Tigray-elected and leading PERI, that has been fighting the Abiy Ahmed and invited invaders since November 2020, said they could leave occupied territories in neighboring regions if humanitarian corridors were provided and the blockade by the government lifted. From the beginning, the humanitarian was imbalanced and incorrect because it did not include the exclusion of the genociders from Tigray western, northwest, central and eastern zones. These TPLF conditions came 3 weeks after a mediated truce was announced to allow humanitarian aid to reach Tigray, but which TPLF and aid agencies said have only been a trickle. Efforts to have lasting peace depends on consistent aid delivery, for now. And even the West, which initially pushed for dialogue, has been keen on cessation of violence and access to humanitarian aid. Last week's delivery of humanitarian assistance in Tigray is welcome news. But make no mistake, more help is needed, said Linda Thomas Greenfield, the U.S. ambassador to the UN in a statement, which adds that humanitarian access to Tigray, and the resumption of basic services, including electricity, telecommunications, and banking, is vital. This week, the TPLF wrote an open letter to the UN, suggesting the region's continued blockade will not help peace. Related to a past United Nations Security Council meeting in New York. UN Security Council meets over security, humanitarian aid in Tigray, WHO Director General Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus. WHO chief accuses world of double standards in crises Ethiopia. Ethiopia in image crisis over Tigray atrocities. A youngster arranges food aid on a cart first aid convoy on its way to war-hit Tigray. There has been a regrettably mistaken assumption on the part of the international community that the decision by Tigray forces to withdraw from neighboring regions in December was enough to ensure Ethiopia's peace and security, it said, arguing it deployed troops into Afar and Amhara as a response to the crisis, not to cause it. In reality, the deployment of our forces outside Tigray was the result, not the driver, of the crisis that have been convulsing the country. There is no doubt that the current status quo is unsustainable, replete as it is with a number of interlocking socio-economic, political and security elements that, if not attended to urgently, will lead to the collapse of the state, and the disintegration of the country's social fabric, which is already hanging by a thread. Conditions on Thursday, the rebels issued 4 preconditions to fully withdraw from neighboring Afar region. First, that there should be safe corridors for the delivery of vital humanitarian aid. Second, a system be put in place to facilitate the provision of adequate humanitarian assistance. Third, the lifting of the long-imposed, abhorrent blockade on Tigray. And fourth, the restoration of essential socio-economic services. These conditions, Tigray elected government said, should be verified by an independent, impartial entity such as the UN. It is unknown whether the government will agree to the conditions. Meanwhile, the World Food Programme said on Thursday that more food trucks could be dispatched to Tigray to deliver food. The Tigray People's Liberation Front, TPLF, the elected Tigray regional government that has been fighting the government since November 2020, said they could leave occupied territories in neighboring regions if humanitarian corridors were provided and the blockade by the government lifted.
Efforts to have lasting peace depends on consistent aid delivery, for now. And even the West, which initially pushed for dialogue, have been keen on cessation of violence and access to humanitarian aid. T-Tube argues the international organizations are adding fuel to the fire. They are helping the butcher Abiy Ahmed Ali and his allied powers, including the centuries dictator Azias Afewerki of Eritrea, Evin. The statements, a petition in calling Tigray government as rebel group and the butcher and genocider Abiy Ahmed as a government. The statements they publish are the copies of the butcher and genociders. The international communities and the USA, which is leading Tigray genocide to fulfill the aim of the Illuminati 666, is now remaining silent while it was crying to turn TDF from entering Addis Ababa. All international organizations are helping the butcher Abiy Ahmed Ali to say some. The World Bank, which is granting multi-billion dollars as a reward of the crisis that is waged by the butcher and genocider on the people of Tigray. Mind you, one of the aim of the Illuminati is war and human crisis that can highly sweep poor people, especially the black and Asians. The decision of TPLF to negotiate with the butcher and deceptive Abiy Ahmed is creating anger and Tigrayan and Ethiopian elites who wanted the end of the crisis.